National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Los Angeles Chargers and the Cleveland Browns. Coming up next.
On the banks of Lake Erie, a look inside Cleveland Browns Stadium in downtown Cleveland. Said Mike Tirico and Greg Olson with you. Buckle up, partner. I think this is going to be an aerial show. Both of these teams giving us the hint that the ball's going to be in the air a lot in this one.
No question. I think both teams were very clear in our weekly meetings that that was going to be the plan. And what we see right now in today's modern football, Mike, is the direct correlation between explosive plays. In this case, two teams that rely on those explosives coming in the passing game and the direct ability to score points. At the end of the day, this is who can score the most points. And if you want to score points today, it's going to become by throwing the ball deep downfield as often as you can.
Cameron Dicker has the ball teed up as we get underway. Off we go from Cleveland. And a decent return there. We'll get this up just shy of the 30. The Browns led out by their quarterback, Deshaun Watson. The stardom early in Houston. Now his third season with the Browns, eighth season in the league, as Watson tries to get this Browns team going in this one.
He spent a lot of time, Mike, over these last couple days speaking to the media. And the thing that jumped out to me was just how confident he was in his team's preparation ahead of today's game. Now, only time will tell or not whether it makes a difference, but if his confidence is any indication of how they're going to perform, this could be a tough team to beat.
Watson going to throw right away. Open man, that's Amari Cooper. And he's going to get this one out to the 43-yard line. A gain of 14. Good for a quick first down.
And really the key to this play was just how fast he was able to get through his progressions. His mind was able to process and go from one to two to three so quickly that he was able to get the ball to the right target on time. And I think so often those two things are different. Being open is one thing. Being open and getting the ball on time, that's what leads to success. And that's what we saw here.
Second and seven. Out of the gun, Watson. And that ball in and out of his hands. It is incomplete. Might tell you after the game, he should have come up with that one. He doesn't. And now third down comes up.
So the receiver does everything right, except for the most important part. He runs a nice route, great separation downfield. But now you just got to finish that thing off with a catch.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And that is incomplete.
Remember what they told us, Mike, leading up to this game. They said it is so critical for us to find success, especially on third down. We want to maintain possession, extend these drives. Well, the first crack comes up, and they fail through the air. And we're going to have to regroup and be able to have better success throughout the remainder of this game.
No return forthcoming. It's a touchback, and we'll come out to the 20-yard line. The Chargers led out by Justin Herbert in his fifth season out, Greg, as the Charger QB, a guy we saw win the Offensive Rookie of the Year in 2020.
His skill set can be determined by the letter A. Arm talent, accurate, athletic, and he's got a kind of aura about him. There's something special that they know when he's under center, we have a shot. First-round pick. He's got everything you want for the quarterback position. He needs to take that next step from being a legitimate, bona fide franchise quarterback to a superstar in the NFL.
That's to the big tight end, Parham. And he's out of bounds, up beyond the 40-yard line. Terrific start to this drive. Gain of 23 and a first down.
This is a great example of why teams want to stay out of what they call passing downs, where a defense doesn't have to honor the run. In this case, they do, And man, the play action pass just works off of that and can really lead to some chunk plays.
Now the free agent pickup from Baltimore. It's Gus Edwards. And they will finally drag him down at the Chargers 27-yard line. They are cooking to begin this drive. This play going for 30 yards.
I think it's clear this is something this offense wants to major in, the ability to run the ball. After that big game, you have to imagine they're going to come back to it and dare them to stop it.
They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Now a play fake. Herbert. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down.
They told us this week they were going to try to come out fast. And tell you what, that's exactly what they did. Put immediate pressure on this secondary and let them know, hey, all game long today, you better defend every blade of grass because we're coming out firing. And even though that ball falls incomplete, it goes a long way in setting up the rest of this game plan as the game unfolds.
He is dangerous when a play breaks down. A pickup of 18.
This has been a great drive, and mostly at the hands of the man with the ball there. He thought about pulling the trigger on that one, thought better of it, decides to take off with his legs, and now he's going to have first and goal.
They'll run here with Edwards. Some room to run as he takes it down to the 2-yard line. Now here's second and goal. Now Herbert. That's to the end zone, but they can't connect. It's incomplete.
They went for it all on that one and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and they got some big plays in their future.
They'll try and run. Edwards. And he is not going to get in to make the tackle at the line of scrimmage. That's going to bring up fourth and goal.
This runner, Mike, just to get back to the line of scrimmage. I think most backs around the league, that play would have resulted in a loss, but not this guy. Continued to fight, continued to do everything he could to prevent the loss, but it still stopped for no gain.
The offense staying put. Fourth and goal from the 2. They'll try to run. And he's not going to get there. They stopped him at the goal line. It's a turnover on downs.
And here we have a real gutsy call here, Mike, early in this game offensively. I think you're giving up a surefire field goal attempt, but at the same time, you're demonstrating to your players, hey, offense, I have a lot of trust in you. And let's see if they have this same approach as the rest of this game plays on.
They'll come up here, first and 10. They'll start on the ground with Chubb. And nothing doing there. Might get it out to the 2, but that's all. Here's second and 9. Once again, it's Chubb. And he's bottled up after a gain of a yard. Now after the run, we get a stoppage for an injured player. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. They're going to try to pick this up on third and eight. Here's Watson. He's got the hook up there to Cooper. He's going to be hit after the catch, and the ball comes free. Well, a big play there, and maybe a big break, too. The ball going out of bounds, so they keep possession and keep a little bit of this momentum going, Greg.
We see this across the league so much now, Mike. Defenders are getting so good at ripping that ball out. Unfortunately for them, in this case, they got the ball out, but it ended up going out of bounds.
Watson, gonna give it to Chubb. And this defense not allowing much there. They'll stop him at the 45. They'll come up on a second down and eight. Shotgun snap to Watson. Oh, and this one's going to wind up incomplete. That's one you'd think he'd be able to corral. He can't find the handle, and it's going to lead to a third down.
He decides to go with the safe throw and throws it well short of the sticks. And at this level, Mike, you just can't miss layups like that.
From the gun, here on third down, Watson. That'll be intercepted. He's going to give his offense a short field to work with as they look for their first points of the game.
So the first part of any interception is just end up with the ball in your hands, right? That's what every defensive coordinator wants. But anytime you can get yards on the return, that's just an added bonus. And that's what we see here. There's a little space, does a great job securing the catch, and all of those yards just set up for better field position as their offense takes the field.
The Chargers offense ready to see what they can do on their second possession. They'll start with a short field looking for the first points of this contest. And they'll begin first and 10. Shotgun now for Herbert. That's the rookie from Georgia. It's Ladd McConkey. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9. Second and a yard. Up the middle, here's Edwards. And that should be enough. He works his way forward to pick up a first down.
This offense, they're not interested in taking the deep shot here. Second and short, the way they're running the ball, pound the rock, reset the downs, and just keep the drive alive.
Set to go now on first and 10. They'll go back to Edwards on first down. And he's fighting to try to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not do it. This is going to be a loss of a yard.
Every team makes an emphasis on winning first down, but as a defense, when you're able to take them back for a loss, second and long, you can really become more of a pass-centric defense and really tips the scales into your favor.
They run once more with Edwards. Maybe a couple there. It's third down. From the gun, it's Herbert. And this is going to be incomplete. That's great work to get in there and make things difficult defensively, setting up a fourth down.
It's always a risky decision anytime a quarterback tries to force the ball, especially into those tightly contested areas. Not a lot of daylight, not a lot of room for error. In this case, it just falls simply as an incomplete. But as this game unfolds, better decisions are going to lead to better results. And I think this is going to end up being considered a successful drive, Mike. I think obviously you would have loved to see them come down and convert and score a touchdown. But at the very least, they needed to come away with three. They were able to do that and take a lead on that field goal.
So after the field goal to open up the scoring, the kicker's back out for this kickoff. This one taken at the 7. And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line.
There's no doubting the fact, Mike, they've made a clear point in saying we need to get this guy the ball as often as possible. And so far, they've had great success when they have gotten him the ball. I think defensively, at some point, you've got to find a way to get this duo out of this rhythm, or they're going to be in for a long game.
On the ground, it's Chubb to start this drive. Strong running there, pushing his way forward to gain a couple. They bring Judy in motion. Using the jet sweep for the fake, they run it up the middle. Fighting off tackles, pushing his way forward. Good gain of about 4. They'll come up to 3rd and 3. The shotgun. Here's Watson. He's got his man complete. That's Judy.
Doing a nice job there to move the chains early in this drive, but now as they approach midfield, continue to keep your foot on the gas. Don't get conservative. Don't start sitting on the ball. Cross midfield and go. Anytime you find yourself in your opponent's side of the field, you have to be thinking points.
A fresh set of downs to work with. It is 1st down and 10. To throw is Watson. That's caught left side by Cooper. And he's down on the other side of midfield. Markham at the 48-yard line. 4 catches already in this opening quarter. Off to a hot start as he picks up the 1st down. Now Chubb. And they'll take this down inside with 35. Give them 17 more, and they are on a roll. Another 1st down.
This offense has to be thrilled, Mike, with the success they've had here on the ground in this opening quarter. Now as the rest of the game unfolds, everything in the game plan continues to open up.
That's caught downfield by Cooper. 19 more on that one, and another 1st down.
Offensively, landing a lot of body blows on this drive, Mike. Just the ability to steadily march the ball downfield and remain so efficient, both run and pass. As they continue to wear this defense out, they have to find a way to end this drive with points. Anything short of that, be a bit of a letdown.
And the Browns are going to be set up with a 1st and goal. And a pass play that moves them down to the 1.
They've done a nice job spreading the ball around. Make the defense have to account for as many different weapons as possible here early. And think back to our conversation with this coaching staff, Mike. They identified this guy as someone they needed to get involved early and often. So that might be his first target. I don't think it's going to be his last.
To the goal line and in. David Njoku. Touchdown, Browns. Dustin Hopkins now to add the extra point. It's up and through. And the Browns move out to a 7-3 lead. Once more, as the kick's away. Now return coming from the 7. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. So now here comes the Chargers as they get set to take over once more. The trail by 4, a touchdown gives them the lead. Drive begins with 1st and 10. Here for Herbert. He's got Parham, his tight end. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. Terrific start to this drive. Gain of 23 and a 1st down.
In order for this play to be successful against man coverage, Mike, 2 things need to happen. 1, the quarterback has to anticipate the break. He has to get that ball out on time. And then the rest is the receiver creating the separation at the top. And when both are accomplished, you can see what the results are.
Here's 1st and 10. Now, a handoff to Edwards. And a nice run there. He'll be stopped just shy of a 1st down. A pickup of 9. So after 1, it's the Browns with the advantage. And we're back to Cleveland in a minute. An enviable spot to operate from. Here's 2nd and inches. On the handoff, Edwards. He's going to fight forward. Didn't get a whole lot, but it's going to be enough to move the chains.
It's possible they could have tried to be a little bit more aggressive on 2nd down, knowing they had 3rd and inches in their back pocket. But I don't think anyone's going to complain. Pick up the 1st down, extend the drive, see if you can go score.
Looking middle, and he'll get it complete to McConkey. And they'll move this ball way down into the red zone, inside the 20-yard line. 20-yard pickup there. It's good for a Charger 1st down.
Not a whole lot complicated about this play, Mike. That was understanding where the holes of the defense were. Remember, in this zone coverage, you got to find green grass, get past the 1st down marker, be friendly to the quarterback, and then the ball has to be out on time before those zone defenders can react to the receiver. It's exactly how it played out here. You can drop all the fancy plays you want, but when the quarterback and the receiver see it through the same set of eyes, it's virtually impossible to stop.
A gain of 11, and it's 1st and goal.
We've seen this trend throughout the league, Mike. Offensively, everyone wants to have depth at the running back position. Yeah, it's great to have one guy, but if you could have 2 or 3 that could all come in and contribute on the ground, that's the goal, and we're seeing it here.
Out of the gun, here's Herbert. That's hauled in at the 2. And he's going to be down close to the goal line. Good job defensively to make sure he did not get to the end zone.
I really like the balance that they've showed so far on this drive, Mike, and what that does is it makes the defense have to defend the entire field. The run game and the pass game, everything looks the same. There's no tech.
Powering forward, he's in. Gus Edwards. Touchdown, Chargers. A lot of big bodies down there, but at the end of the day, the one that mattered, the one with the ball, finds the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, once that back gets the ball, Mike, he's just looking for a little crack of daylight, and he's thinking, I'm going to run into it and just hope I come out the other side. And in this case, the other side's the end zone, and they get six.
Cameron Dicker, the kicker for the extra point. The kick is good, and the Chargers are on top. It's now 10-7. Kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. This returnable from the four. The Browns offense and quarterback Deshaun Watson getting set for their next drive. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides as this drive kicks off with first and 10. To throw is Watson on the quick slant. That's Judy, and that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards. Here's second and 3 to go. Fake the handoff. Now Watson. Right back to Judy. He's got it again. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield. That's his third catch of this first half, and good enough for a first down.
This is clinic tape for any young wide receiver out there watching this guy run routes. He has the defender thinking everything is a go ball. Attack him vertically, and then when you get to your route depth, you stick that foot in the ground, you break in, balls on time, results in a nice first down pickup.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. He's got it in the hands of Elijah Moore. And they'll take this down inside the 35. First time these two have connected this afternoon, and it'll wind up being a first down.
Great pre-snap identification by the quarterback, realizing that the blitz was coming and exactly where the soft spot in the defense would be. He's able to put that slant route right on the front shoulder pad of his receiver, leads to a real nice run after catch, and brings up first down.
And he maneuvers his way forward, a gain of 6. They'll work now on second and 4. They'll go with Chubb. We'll get this inside the 20, and nice run there in the red zone. It's first down.
I think this second down call, Mike, they were hoping that at worst, they had themselves set up for a third down and short. But there's no need for third down. He was able to get enough on second, and they get a fresh set of downs.
On the ground, it's Chubb. And the Browns are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Well, this is the advantage to having a really effective passing game, Mike, as the defense now tries to adjust to stopping you through the air. It's a lot easier to mix it up and run the ball. There's a lot less defenders in there trying to stop it.
Throwing is Watson. to the end zone there, but it is incomplete.
For the most part, he's been very accurate with the ball. I mean, he's completing over 60% of his passes, but because they haven't been able to get any big explosive plays, continue to push the ball downfield, hasn't really translated on the scoreboard just yet.
Moore going in motion. They fake the jet sweep and give it up the middle. And the defense stiffening here. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's all. Third and goal coming up.
Well, after the failures of the first and second down, you got to look now at your third down call sheet. Every play caller has a section. Must-have-it plays, critical downs. I say this one falls in that category, and we'll see what they have up their sleeve.
Now Watson on third and goal. That one, take it in. Nick Chubb, touchdown Cleveland. The quarterback with all of his eligible receivers available uses the back out of the backfield that time, Greg, to take it to the end zone.
And when your running back, Mike, is a valid threat in the passing game, man, it just gives you so many options. And in this case, it was the running back that was the open target. He's able to put the pass on the money. Easy 6 points.
Now Hopkins on to add the extra point. He's got it. And the Browns are on top. It's 14-10. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Here's Darius Davis to return it. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Chargers offense and Gus Edwards heading back on the field for the next drive. They'll do so with first and 10. Throwing now is Herbert. He connects with Disley. On the give. It's Edwards. And they'll be set up now. Up past the 40 with that one. A pickup of 12 yards. And the Chargers have the first down.
The goal of every offense, Mike, is to find a way to establish a balance between the run and the pass. With some success here early on the ground, we'll open up things as the game unfolds for the quarterback in this passing game.
He's got the connection there. It's Joshua Palmer. And he's down inside the 40-yard line. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. And as the medical staff looks him over, we'll step aside. Ball rests at the 37. It's first and 10. On play action. Now Herbert. That's to the big tight end, Parham. And he's out of bounds all the way inside the 15-yard line. That's his third catch of this first half, and good enough for a first down.
That quarterback called that play in the huddle. That ball was only going to one guy. He was the first read, the second read, and the check down, and it was called to perfection. They got the perfect look and led to a nice game.
First and 10. Now Herbert on the bootleg. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They got him.
Pretty evident that the defense is just giving no time of day to any run actions. They are playing pass all the way, and he can continue to give as many play action fakes as he wants. It hasn't affected anybody, and in this case, it results in a sack.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long. Here's Herbert. Right side, hauled in by McConkey. Third and long. Now it's Herbert. That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Glad McConkey the one he was looking for. And that'll set up fourth down.
They let a golden opportunity slip away on that one. That's the matchup that they wanted. They just couldn't quite capitalize it.
He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Chargers are back within a point. It's 14-13.
And I can tell you firsthand, Mike, when you find yourself trailing in a game, you don't feel very good about coming away with field goals. But in this case, it does get them a little bit closer and cut into this deficit.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. To return is Naheem Hines, and he's brought down right at the 25-yard line.
And another great throw right there, Mike, and when you take a look at the numbers, they certainly don't lie. He has just been flat-out terrific in this first half. His ability to spread the ball around, take what the defense has given him, they've certainly had a lot of success here early on.
From the 25, they'll go to work. First and 10. A run up the middle with Chubb. And a good job following his blockers. A gain of 7. It'll be second down. In a tight 1-point game in this first half. We'll have more from Cleveland after this. Third and 2, and it's Watson. He's got his man, right side, it's complete.
Mike, I think we make so much of all these fancy routes, right? The selling, the head fakes, getting in and out of the break. And while that's really important to create separation, that's really more of a man beater. That's when teams want to just play you one-on-one and you have to beat the defender. Against zone defense, like we saw here, it's a lot more simpler. Understand the concept of the play, understand where the holes in the defense are, and get there and be friendly to the quarterback. And if you're open, stay open. That's NFL route running. That's what the best guys do. Throughout this entire game, we've really seen this quarterback operate very efficiently, not only being able to spread the ball to multiple playmakers, Mike, but really complete a high percentage of his passes. So can't let that last incomplete break what's been a really nice rhythm so far.
Now sets up a screen for Chubb. Third and five. Watson to throw again. He'll try and get there on the ground. And he's out of bounds, but not until he gets inside the 25-yard line.
You certainly can't fault the secondary here. The coverage was almost too good downfield on third down. The quarterback realized quickly there was nowhere for him to go with the ball, decides to become a runner. He's able to pick up the first down and some.
Now, first down throw for Watson. Back over the middle and caught by Judy. And he's going to be taken down. 17 yards on the game, and now they've got first and goal.
This is what every offense looks to do, Mike. They want to attack the middle of the field. That's the most valuable real estate in football. Oftentimes, that's where the chunk plays come. Give it to your receiver on the move and let them do the rest.
A couple of big plays, one after the other, and now it's first and goal. From the shotgun, here's Watson. He'll tuck it and take off. The Browns going to use the first of their timeouts here, as they'll stop it just a little bit over 30 seconds to go in this first half. From the two nap, here's second and goal. They'll run with Chubb. And he won't quite get in. Down to the one, setting up third and goal. Njoku, the tight end, is the one in motion. He'll run with Chubb. And he'll just get up inside those big bodies up front. And he's in. Nick Chubb. Touchdown, Browns. He had the touchdown catch earlier. This time he takes it in on the ground. So on third and goal, they run it in. Sometimes, Greg, that's four down territory. They didn't need to do it on fourth down. Taking care of it on the third down for the touchdown.
Yeah, and when you find yourself down here this close, Mike, you have to finish these drives off. I'm with you. I think he was going to give his back two shots there to punch it in, but he only needed one.
Much time on the clock to put together a drive here at the end of the first half. And the kickoff's coming their way. Davis now to return it. They'll get this up past the 20. That's where they'll set up shop. The Chargers offense and their running back getting ready to go back to work. But deficit is 8 as this drive begins with first and 10. Now for Herbert. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. 16 yards on the game and a quick first down.
We see this week in and week out, Mike. These running backs in today's game, they really have the skill set of a wide receiver. So if you're going to guard him one-on-one, and you know the offense is going to use him in the passing game, you better have that guy. You better have that matchup guy that you're confident to put on him and say, okay, you're going to go out there in space and defend a receiver like this. And after plays like that, I'm not sure how much more man coverage they can afford to play.
On first down, Herbert. Now a screen set up for Edwards. It'll be taken down rather swiftly after a gain of just three. Here's Cameron Dicker now on for the field goal. This a 57-yard attempt. And that is no good. He missed it. So we hit halftime here in Cleveland, and the Browns are in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando now, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Mike, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our halftime report. We saw a solid first half out of the workhorse Nick Chubb. He found the end zone twice, once on the ground and once in the passing game, as he proved he's anything but a one-dimensional running back.
Okay, Coach, thanks a bunch. We'll see which team's adjustment's going to pay dividends here. Likely going to play a big role in who wins this one. Third quarter set to commence. And we're back underway here on EA Sports. Davis now to return it. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Chargers offense going to have a first crack at it as we begin this third quarter. They'll start it here with a first and 10. Herbert keeping it on the zone read. And some good running there. He'll fall forward for about 7.
Good decision by the quarterback. In this situation, all you're looking to do is have a positive play. He decides to pull it, and that's exactly what he's able to do.
Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. He connects with Palmer on that one. And they'll get him down after a gain of 5, but that is enough for a first down.
We hear the term RPO so often, Mike, and it continues to kind of trickle its way into the NFL. But remember, it's a lot different in the NFL than it is in the college game, where it's a lot more prevalent. The lineman cannot go downfield. So that quarterback has to make a lot of really fast snapshot decisions, or else it's going to lead to a penalty or him holding on to the ball too long. So it's something that teams want to implement, but maybe not quite to the level that we see in the college game.
They'll come up here on 2nd down and 5. From the gun, it's Herbert. This one complete to Palmer. And they're going to work this down inside the 45. That's the 2nd time they connect on this drive. This one good for 13 yards. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for 1st and 10. Running straight ahead with Edwards. And he'll get this down inside the 40-yard line. That's a gain of 5 yards. Fake the handoff. Now Herbert. That's complete to the TCU man, Quentin Johnston.
Still second down.
The defense there to meet him. They'll hold him to two and bring up third down. Out of the gun, here's Herbert. Is caught on the sideline and both feet inbounds. A big third down pickup for a first down.
Well, they finally are able to convert on a third down. And Mike, when you look back at a box score, some of the biggest indications of how well the game went, of course, you don't want to turn the ball over. How do you execute in the red zone? And then how are you on third down? Third downs typically lead to long drives. Long drives tend to lead to points. Not a real complicated formula. Stay on the field. The more snaps, the more plays, the better.
Oh, and a short throw there, but it's going to end up incomplete. That's a pass he say he should have had. Instead, he does not, and it brings up second down.
It's rare to see an offense that finds themselves trailing and say, well, their quarterback's been actually one of their biggest bright spots. Usually that doesn't go hand in hand, so it's a little surprising to see him miss a throw like that on a day where he's completed passes at a highly efficient rate.
Out of the gun, they'll give it to Edwards. And he will score. Gus Edwards, touchdown LA. That is second touchdown of the afternoon. So now Herbert and the Chargers will go for two. Now Herbert. He's got a man. Take it in for two. And we are all tied here in the third quarter.
Mike, I think all of us can remember exactly where we were during a certain Super Bowl where throwing the ball this close to the goal line ended up being a disaster. But unlike that time, they ran this pass play to perfection and the result, 2 points.
So back to level after the touchdown. Time for the kickoff. Here's Hines now to return. He's across the 20, taken down just shy of the 25. The offense headed back out, captained, of course, by their quarterback. And he has been in control this offense. Want to run you through some of the action from earlier on. You've got the two touchdown passes, over 200 passing yards. He has been excellent all game long. So here's a first and 10 now. They'll start from the 24. Back to throw is Watson. That is incomplete.
When you air it out like that on these big shots downfield, they're not always high percentage plays. It takes a lot of things to line up timing-wise, location of the field, accuracy of the throw to result in those big plays. But I think they've got to continue to search for those and try to generate a little bit of a spark.
To throw on second down is Watson. And they'll hold him to a gain of just a couple and sets up third down.
When you put plays like this on tape, it sends a message to every defender across the league. When you play this offense and this guy has the ball, you better bring it when you come to contact him, because if not, you're going to be on the wrong end of it.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And that is incomplete.
And barring an aggressive decision here on fourth down, it just seemed like a really wasted possession to go three and out, not able to pick up a single first down. Not only do you not able to gain any field position advantage, it really takes a lot of the wind out of your sails as you find yourself jogging off the field and the punt team coming on.
Man. And he's going to be knocked down before he can even think about returning that one. Whoa. The visitors' offense and their running back getting set for this next possession. And as we look at the highlights, you see it's been tough to stop him here today. Couple of touchdowns in this ball game. He has, without a doubt, been the driving force in this offense so far. On first and 10, here's Herbert. He's going to keep it himself.
You know, Mike, nice job here by the quarterback just understanding on these early downs, you just don't want to go backwards. So he's able to avoid the negative play, pick up a little bit, and mostly avoid the sack.
To throw is Herbert. That one's complete to Johnston. And that's going to be a first down. A pickup of 9.
A gain of 9 yards. First down, Los Angeles.
Throwing, Herbert. Gets it away quickly, and it's caught. And they bring him down, but not until he crosses midfield. A gain there of 10 yards. It's good for a Charger first down.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play, and it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion, and then really it's the yards after catch that did the rest, and that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there.
Here's a 2nd and 6. Now Herbert on the bootleg. Comeback route, and he's got it. And they bring him down, but not until they get inside the 30-yard line. They hook up again, second time on this drive, and this one's good for 18 yards and a first down.
Now, so far here today, putting points on the board certainly hasn't been a problem, and plays like that are why. Think about it, Mike. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you and not force something that's not there, and that mid-range pass results in a fresh set of downs.
From the gun, give to Edwards. And he searches forward for a gain of about 5. Inside the 10, it is caught, and he'll be taken down. He's over 100 receiving yards on the afternoon now, and a first down to boot.
Talk about a thing of beauty. Mike, did you see how many tight ends were on the field on that last play? They call it 13 personnel because there's one running back, three tight ends, one wide receiver. So everybody on defense is thinking run. They catch him off guard a little with the pass, and they take advantage of it with a big gain downfield.
A run on first and goal. They'll get maybe a yard down to the four-yard line. Inside the five, it is second and goal. They'll run it with Edwards. And he won't quite get in. Down to the one, setting up third and goal. Sets up fourth and goal.
Well, this seems pretty straightforward. Third and one, just dial up a run play and run straight downhill. But this defense had other plans. They were ready and expecting that run, and they're able to take the ball carrier down for a loss.
Dicker's kick is good. And the Chargers will take a 24-21 lead.
Job number one on this drive, find a way to get the lead. They, of course, would have loved to score a touchdown, Mike. But 3 points here, that's a pretty good consolation prize as it moves him out in front.
Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Here's Hines now to return. And he'll be taken down right at the 29-yard line. Well, there's Amari Cooper as he and the Browns get set for their next possession. They'll begin with first and 10. Start on the ground with Chubb. And a minimal gain here, only to about the 31. On second down, here's Watson. Over the middle to his tight end, Njoku. He'll mark him down up at the 44-yard line. He's got a touchdown on the books from earlier, and that catch gets him a first down.
Just seems like every year, Mike, the tight end position just continues to grow within the passing game and establishes a bigger and bigger role. And listen, I know I'm biased, but if you want to have a good passing game, you better have a good tight end.
And good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground. We'll come to the line now on 2nd and 2. So, 3 quarters now in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Here's Watson now on second down. That's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Christian Fulton. What a time for a pick six for the defense as the other team is trying to get themselves right back in this one. The defense extends the margin with the pick six.
Yeah, just a critical moment. You find yourself on defense, Mike, trying to hang on to this lead. And not only do you do that, you pick six them and you're able to extend that lead.
Point after now from Dicker. He gets it to go. And the Chargers will open it up even further here in this fourth quarter. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Here comes a return from the five. He'll get across the 20, mark him down at the 23-yard line. So now, out comes the offense, led by their quarterback as they take over once again. And this defense has really had their way so far, intercepting him twice, forced into a number of bad throws. And generally, the D has just made it tough to operate all game long. Operating from their own 23, they'll begin first and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. That's into the hands of Moore.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle prevents that from turning into a big play.
Second and 7. Shotgun snap to Watson. Going up top. And he's got it! And he's going to take this one all the way. 74 yards. Touchdown, Cleveland. He has come alive after the break. His third touchdown of the second half. Hopkins now to tack on the extra point. It's up and good. And the Browns are back within a field goal. The lead is 3. They've cut into the lead, now just a field goal behind as they kick it off. From the 6, here comes a return. Across the 20, they'll mark them down before the 25-yard line. That's where the offense will take over.
And what's that one thing you hear from coaches all the time, Mike, right? Finish strong, and he's doing just that. His numbers here in this one, they have been terrific. But he's going to give you a full 4 quarters, and I think at this point in the game, he knows there's even more yards to be had.
They'll come up here, 1st and 10. Yeah.
Herbert to throw. They'll look to set up the screen here. Love to start any drive like that. 18 on the first play. And a first down.
I like the call. Using the screen as a drive starter to pick up a chunk play and get this offense into some rhythm. It's clear this offensive play caller anticipated the rush of the defense, and he was able to use it against them.
Here's Edwards. And he'll get two on this one before being taken down. Look him up on a second down and eight. Again, it's Edwards. And he'll pick his way forward, a gain of about five. And that's going to set up third down. He'll try and run for the first down with Edwards. On fourth down, here comes J.K. Scott to punt. As they try to play the field position game here, protecting a fourth quarter lead. The drive begins at the 20. Here's first and 10. He'll run. Oh, yeah. And he'll manage to get this ahead for a pickup of five.
This just shows why you can't count on just one guy to take him down. He's a powerful enough runner. You've got to have guys coming in support when that first hit is made. It takes a team effort to stop him, especially once he gets going.
From the shotgun, here's Watson. He brings it in, the tight end, Njoku. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up a first down after a gain of seven.
This play is actually really well defended here. But I'll tell you, Mike, as you know, my philosophy is the tight end is always open, and this just supports my case.
They'll keep it on the ground. Run. Get him about nine. It'll bring up second down. They'll run here. And nothing doing on that one. He'll go down behind the line.
How often do we see linebackers be so fast trying to track down the ball carrier that they end up actually overrunning the play and allowing the running back to cut back? But not this guy. Does a great job staying in phase, stretching this ball out sideways, and he brings him down for a loss.
Watson now on third down. That's caught. It's the tight end, Njoku.
Nothing real fancy here, Mike. Not a huge pickup, but anytime on third down, you got to know where the sticks are, who's your most reliable player, and I think everybody in this booth knows exactly what position that is.
A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. They'll stick to the ground. and good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground. Now Watson. That's into the hands of Judy on the right side. Taking advantage of that running ability. Gain of 17 and a first down.
Here in the fourth quarter, you just can't predict how many possessions you have left for the remainder of the game. So you can't let any of them go to waste. So far, this has been a fantastic drive. It's a drive that they desperately needed. They continue to throw the ball like that. They got a chance to take a late lead here in the fourth quarter.
Through the contact, it's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down.
Up until that incompletion, they've done a really nice job on this drive, Mike, picking up fresh sets of downs. And typically, throwing the ball on first down is a great way to do it. It's actually the easiest down in football to operate in. But now they find themselves in second and 10. Do you keep it in the air and try to get the first down here? Or is the idea to just make third down manageable and take your chances picking up a key third down? Oftentimes, it's the wide open ones that are the hardest to catch. It seems like the ball is in the air forever. You start overthinking it. You start really making more of it than what you should, and you let it slip away.
On third down, they go with Chubb. Four touchdowns for him on the afternoon. What a game this has been. Back and forth we go, and that fourth quarter score changes the lead one more time.
And we've seen the lead go back and forth, Mike, and now the question is, can they get a stop? Can they find a way defensively to hang on to this lead and get themselves this big win?
Now Hopkins on to add the extra point. The kick is good, and the Browns have taken a four-point advantage. So now playing with the lead after that fourth quarter touchdown, time to kick it back the other way. Davis now to return it, and he is stopped at 25. The drive will begin then. The visitors' offense ready to take over possession of the football. They'll see if they can put something together here, beginning with first and 10. In this drive, it's Edwards, and he'll pick up two out to the 27. Pistol here for Herbert. Nice work there after the catch. He's a little short of the first down after a gain of 7.
These are the type of plays that drive a coach crazy in the film room, and you have to learn as a quarterback to avoid. You can take some chances. You can push the ball downfield, but not only to pick up a couple yards. You got to pick your chances of when you want to be aggressive, and you got to make sure you make better decisions going forward.
And he'll have the first down. We'll get him up around the 37.
Really just the same approach that an offense would take on a quarterback sneak, Mike. You don't necessarily have to spring him for a huge game. Can you buy just enough space up front to pick up 1 yard? That's exactly what they did, pick up the first down.
Herbert now on first down. He connects with Palmer on that one. And they'll have it across midfield, down at the opposing 46-yard line. Second time they've connected on the drive, and this one goes for 17 yards.
As this game continues to come down to the wire, Mike, it just reminds us, this is where quarterbacks earn their keep. You are judged by how you play in these critical moments. And fourth quarter, down a score, it doesn't get much bigger than this.
Set to go now on first and 10. From the gun, it's Herbert. That'll be taken in by Edwards. And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard.
Well, let's give some credit to the big boys up front in the trenches. They knew that blitz was coming. They held up just long enough that the quarterback could get that ball out safely and results in a completion.
They'll come up for second and 9. Shotgun now for Herbert. That one complete to McConkey. And he'll be taken down as the clock ticks towards 2 minutes to play. Pickup of 11 yards on that one. First down, L.A. They'll drop to throw. Who else? Another catch for his favorite target.
This is one of those throws where you're hoping you do most of the damage after the catch, but give credit to the defense. Once that ball was caught, they were on him quickly, and there was nowhere for him to go after the catch.
Here comes second down. Dobbins. Finding space at the 15. And they'll finally run him down, but he takes it inside the 10-yard line. Now, first and goal. No problem. Oh, he can't get rid of it, and he's taken down.
And now we're seeing the game kind of go back and forth. Each team trading blows, trying to establish control over the other. Nice chunk play on the previous play. The defense responds back with a sack, and we'll see which team can establish a little bit more of this control as the game unfolds.
From back at the 13-yard line, it is second and goal. Out of the gun, here's Herbert. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
So now after that last incompletion, this brings up a critical third down. But remember, Mike, they don't have to get it all here in one play. They've got third and fourth down. There's no punt, there's no kick. They've got to treat this like it's their final possession of the game, and they've got two downs to extend this drive.
That is incomplete. Here we go. They're down to what could be their final play. It's fourth down.
They desperately needed that one, Mike. Down here late, they've only got a few remaining snaps to go, and it puts all of the pressure of the game now on fourth down. Let's see what play call they have in a gotta-have-it situation. And right now, this quarterback needs to make his best throw in the biggest moment of the game. What a stand there. Fourth and goal, game on the line. It looks like this offense is putting together a game-winning drive, and the defense comes out with the stop of the day.
Nick Chubb and the rest of the Browns offense set to take over again. This will begin at their own 13-yard line. So work to do starting with this first and 10. On the ground, it's Chubb to start this drive. And he'll get about 5. Now a timeout Chargers here. That's their second. Get the stoppage with just over 50 seconds to go in this one. Once again, it's Chubb. And he's fighting to get free. A lot of work there for a gain of 3. Victory formation here as he's down to a knee. And he'll get a few yards back here on the return before being forced out of bounds. This is first and 10. Here's Herbert. He's going to look downfield for Chark. And that's going to be incomplete. The defense holds here in the final minute, and they're going to get out of here with a victory. So the Dog Pound celebrates. It's a win for the Browns. This was a game where both offenses were up and down the field, marching the ball at will, matching each other point for point. In the end, got a few more defensive stops than their opponents did. That was the difference in this one. And that'll do it for my partner, Greg Olson. For our entire team, I'm Mike Tirico. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Dog Pound's happy. It's a win for the Browns.